Ladies and gentlemen, hello.
Haha, it's me again, Mr. Pink Shoelace, aka Hassan Dejani, coming with you tonight. I love this song so much, and guess why? Because I made it? Nah, it's because it's the best song in the world that I made. Haha. So, how is everyone doing this Saturday night? Welcome to Saturday Night Live. I can't use that because that is copyrighted or whatever. Saturday Night Late Night Saturday Night. Last Wave Radio Broadcast Thing Whatever. DJ Pink Shoelace is in the house. So, today, important stuff, we're going to be talking about time management. And we're going to be talking about how to, save your time and, pro tips. And fun thing, right before this show, it was, 7:30 p.m. And I really was hungry and I needed to eat some food. So, and I have a late night Saturday night show to host at 8 p.m. So what sorts of time management skills could you endure in your daily life, basically, to basically figure out of ways how to improve your time management skills? We're gonna be talking about time management today, and we talked about time management in college classes today. Not today, but a couple weeks ago when I was in college. Today is Saturday. Jeez, honestly, the quarantine pandemic, I have no idea if this has anything to do with the quarantine pandemic, but I feel like every single day is the same. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, eeny, meeny, manny, mo. And the thing is, if you're busy every single day, like me, I'm constantly on the hustle. Every day seems like the same, pretty much. You don't know what day it is. And same thing if you're lazy and playing video games all day, and you dropped out or something. I'm not calling out on anyone, but I'm just saying this as a fact. Your brain will think of time as different. And as the same, I mean. Because every single day, every different day that you're doing the same thing doesn't register differently in your mind. Which means if you're doing, let's say you're doing an action or playing a video game or going to a work or going to school, and then you do the same thing over and over again, your brain will be thinking that you're just keep on doing this, and it will ignore the past, kinda. So that's why people, when it's Tuesday or something, and you've been doing something for so long, you lose track of time and you think, wait a minute, isn't it supposed to be Monday or Friday by now? I don't even know what's going on. And today we're going to be talking about time, and specifically time management. But before we do that, before we talk, I want you listen. We're going to listen to some music. And I wonder who's gonna be DJing for today, huh? Who's gonna be doing some of this? Who's gonna do this, huh? None other than me, haha. So today, the song that we're gonna play for today, it's gonna be, which song should I play for you guys? Let's see, most famous songs of 2021. Olivia Rodrigo, let's do that. So I know a lot of you guys are interested in Olivia Rodrigo and her music. And as a treat, I'm going to be playing that for y'all while we workshop. And while you're listening to the song, what would be good is just zone out, man. Just think about the song, listen to it, relax, sit back in it. Oh my God. Nothing happened. I didn't drop anything on the floor or anything. Anyways, here's Olivia Rodrigo. Copyrighted music that will get me flagged and deleted. But I don't care because, Last Wave Radio has no... It has no, what's that word again? It has no rights in copyright law, so, technically this is, playing it in private and not in public, or... I don't know, as long as we're not, saying that we own the song, it's good, apparently. This is Olivia Rodrigo, Good For You lyrics. Enjoy. Okay, we're gonna play a different song. This one has swear words in it. I didn't know it had swear words. I hope this one doesn't have swear words. This is Olivia Rodrigo Traitor lyric video playing right now. Hopefully it doesn't have swear words like the other one. I didn't know it had swear words. I'm sorry, Alex. I didn't know. Enjoy. So that was Traitor by Olivia Rodrigo, and I'm definitely not eating right now. It is ironic how today I'm going to be talking about time management, yet I am one of the worst people when it comes to time management. Basically, it's kind of like I'm doing this for myself, so. Hold on, I hate the sound of, like, people eating. Just hear this clip that I made. This song, I made it. I'm going to publish it in Spotify, maybe some random time. So listen to this while I finish chewing this food. Alright, fellas, today we're gonna be talking about time management skills. I'm gonna start, but hold on, listen to this. It goes hard, don't it? This is just an excuse for me to show up for the songs that I made. I like my own music, and you should too. I'm kidding, you can like whatever you want. It doesn't matter what you like, because here's the thing. The world is so big. And if you're only gonna matter about what you like and what you don't like, it doesn't matter because everything is just gonna happen anyway. It's gonna happen anyway, and whether you like it or not, it's gonna happen. So, as much as I wanna keep playing this song, I wanna keep going. We have to talk about the topic of the day. Okay. So, actually, I'm gonna keep the bass line, that's kinda cool. So, topic of the day is time management skills and stuff like this, like what to do, time management, how to save your time, and most importantly, how not to waste your time. And wasting time is something that a lot of people are suffering with, because a couple of days ago, actually specifically on Wednesday, I was in a time management skills course. And I'm going to be talking about what we learned during that time after the next song that I'm going to play after this, which is definitely not going to be this. I love this song. I want to play this song next time, like in the next environment or whatever. It's my opening intro song that I'm going to eventually, in a couple of years or months, upload it to Spotify. And I'm Mr. Like, I don't know what I'm talking about, because, believe it or not, I always go off topic. Even when I have a topic in mind, I'm always like, you know what, whatever, I'm just gonna talk about something else. Which is either a strength or a weakness when it comes to conversations. Because I could be having a conversation with someone about spiders, and then I'm gonna be talking about camels, 2 seconds later, and then I'm gonna be talking about how, something about politics, about how, like, the presidential election is rigged. And then they're gonna be like, Hassan, what the hell are, I don't know if I'm allowed to use that word. Alex, I'm sorry. What the heck? There we go. Are you talking about, we were originally talking about spiders. So that's just me. If you don't like it, then you don't have to. As we learned earlier. Oh my god, my lights fell down. Here's another pro tip. Don't get your equipment from Dollarama, because everything is just gonna fall apart. And I'm cheap, so I get my stuff from Dollarama, which I shouldn't. I should get it from Walmart. Which is also cheap, and I shouldn't get it from Walmart. But also, I don't have a lot of money, I'm broke. But also, You gotta live the way you want to live, and not the way people tell you how to live. So anyways, oh my god, I went off topic, and I went off topic of the topic that is off anyway. So the time management lecture, or whatever it was, that I had 2 days ago on Wednesday, in my Vanier College thing, it was during, like, the lunch hour, so it wasn't, like, a class or anything. I went there just for the sake of going there. And we learned a lot of... Don't tell me that the mic is not... Okay, the mic is working. And then we learned... Oh my god, I did not mean to press that button. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to have a siren play. I wanted to press Alt plus Tab to go on the next tab, but then I accidentally pressed X, I think. Wait, which button was that? Well, I pressed a button that made the sound. Which one was it? Oh, it was X. Okay. So I learned something new. If you press C on my DJ software, it plays... Oh my gosh, we have a new listener. Welcome, IP address I'm not going to say out loud. Client name Firefox, if that's you. Welcome to the live broadcast. You have been here for 6 minutes. Oh. Welcome to the live broadcast. This is Late Night Saturday Night with DJ Pink Shoelace, which is me, by the way, if you don't know. Anyways, as I was saying about time management, we learned a lot of skills about... different ways you can, like, save your time. And they said something about... If every single day you got $14.14, like, every single day of your life, like, you wake up the next morning and then, I don't know, the government or your friend or your grandma or your mom gives you $14.14 that you get to keep and do whatever you want with. You can spend it on video games, spend it on savings, spend it on, what was it again? Spend it on, like, if you want to save your money or if you want to spend it on food or... Oh, is that Alex? Alex just texted me, like, recently. He said that he was listening. Many things that you can spend your money on if you had $14 and... $14.40. So... But the thing is... What if... Get this... Like, 2 months from now, let's see, Siri, what is 14.4 times 60? The answer is 864. So then, 2 months from now, it's gonna be $864 that you can do whatever you want with in 2 months. I mean, that's not a lot, like, when it comes to, like, bills and stuff like this and kids... But it is a lot if you are, like, a 13-year-old or a teenager living with their mom or something. Which, you can spend all that money on video... Oh, oops. You can spend that money on video games. You can spend it on whatever you like. But get this. What if you didn't have $864 or whatever that was? Or whatever that was. Let's say every single day you get $14.40, and then the next day, whatever money you didn't spend that day goes into oblivion and disappears. Like, boof, you had $14 yesterday and 40 cents, you bought a slice of pizza for $2, and now you have $12. And then the next day you lose the $12, but you get $14.40 extra. And you might think, oh my god, this is such a science fiction. This will never happen in real life. But the thing is, believe it or not, B-O-I-N, believe it or not, that kind of stuff actually happens to everyone in the world. But it doesn't happen with money. It happens with time. If you have every single day for 1,400 minutes and 1,440 minutes... A day has 24 hours, and you can use that time to spend on whatever you want. You can spend it on watching Netflix, you can spend it hanging out with your friends, or you can spend it doing homework. And if you just wake up one morning and then you're like, you know what, today I'm just going to watch Netflix for 24 hours. You spent 24 hours watching Netflix. And get this. 24 hours of your life has been spent on watching Netflix. Which means you will never in a million years until, like, whatever, some time travel is possible or whatever, never in your life will you get that 24 hours back. You're going to be stuck with the rest of your life having lived 24 hours watching Netflix. Which, some people is like, oh yeah, whatever, I like to watch Netflix, it's my own thing. But to other people who are, like, very time-sensitive, like, they have an assignment due tomorrow or a test they have to study for, now they have 24 hours less to spend time on the test. Or, I don't know, maybe, like, a family member is sick or something. You have 24 hours in your life less to spend time with that person because you prioritize Netflix over something else. And I'm not saying that Netflix is a waste of time. Like, some people, they like Netflix. I think it's a waste of time because, like, why watch a movie when you can just, I don't know, hang out with your friends or something? Like, I feel like there's more valuable things in the world than watching movies. But you can do whatever you want. I'm not telling you what to do. I'm just telling you what I do. Yeah. And, hold on, what did Alex text me? I'm getting sidetracked. Alex says, I'm with you, but time doesn't exist. Yay, yay, yay. Missed call from Alex Von Miller. Shout out to Alex Von Miller, who's watching right now. Let me do a bam, 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 bam. Music make you lose Oops, wrong button. Bruh. Wrong button. There we go. This is for you, Alex. Anyways, what was I saying again? Oh, yeah. So, you spend your time the way you want to prioritize your time. And that's how it is in life. You will never get your time back, because once you spend your time, it's gone. Like with money, you can save money, but you can't save time until you do what I'm about to tell you. And this is kind of like weird advice, but it's not really advice. It's just like a life hack, I guess. Life hack. There we go. Instead of giving advice to someone, just give them a life hack. Say, life hack. Oops, who texted me? There we go. Alex Von Miller texted me saying, loving you. Of course it was Alex. I forgot to turn my phone on silent. That's why I got just... life hack. Whenever you're performing a live performance, always put your phone on silent because you will get distracted if you get a notification. And I have seen it on Fat Man Scoop's live broadcast on Instagram Live, where he's like talking about something very serious and then his phone rings in the middle of the live broadcast, which honestly I find is hilarious, but to him it's very embarrassing because he has to answer the phone while he's on a live broadcast and his phone with his daughter, and it's kind of funny. Like, shout out to Fat Man Scoop. Go on Instagram, Fat Man Scoop. Watch his... He goes on Instagram Live, like, at 6 p.m. Eastern Pacific Time or whatever. And he talks about, like, different stuff, like, a lot of music-related stuff. Which is cool and stuff. Which, if you're interested in hip-hop, he actually interviews celebrities. So if you're interested in that, you can go check it out. Anyways, now we're gonna have a break from my voice. We're gonna listen to some music. I'm gonna be doing some of this. We're gonna be doing some of this. We're gonna be... It's called scratching, by the way. Let's see, what should I play for you guys? Let's see, biggest hits of 2021. I'll key A minor. A minor is pretty cool, I guess. Let's see. We're gonna play for you guys, the listeners out there all over the globe. Actually, like, funny thing is, like, you say, oh, listeners from all over the world or whatever. But also, speaking of time management and stuff like this, listeners from all around time. Because someone could be listening to this in the year 2022. Or in the year 2064. So, shout out to the people who are watching in the year 2062. Wait, hold on. Siri. Hold on. Just give me 1 second. What is 2065 minus 2003?
The answer is 62.
I will be 62 years old in 2065. And somebody in 2065 could be listening to this. So shout out to whoever is listening, or however people are listening. So today we're going to play a very popular song in Canada. It's not popular anywhere else around. It was played in 2016 a lot on Virgin Radio. And I personally like the song. And this song is a good beat, and I believe it's very underrated. It's called Fire in My Soul by Walk Off the Earth. It is not a popular song. It probably has like 1 million views on YouTube or whatever. But we gonna play some. Ready for this? Are you ready for this? We're gonna play it. 3, 2, 1. I got that fire in my soul. Locked and loaded. We're back. Okay, sorry. Hello? Hello? Okay, there we go. Okay, it's working now. Why is it? Don't tell me it wasn't. Of course it's recording, right? Wait, hold on. It should be recording, right? If it's not recording, then too bad, so sad, I didn't record it. But it should be, but worst case scenario, this is just a live broadcast, and we can just use the lower quality whatever broadcast and use that, because I hope it was working. But anyways, so, dashboard paused. We noticed you have not interacted with your whatever. Technology. Honestly, I am very terrible with technology. I know I mentioned this last live broadcast, but technology is just, to me, I don't understand. Which is also a reason why I took a gap year last year for year 2020, 2021. I took a gap year. I took a break from education. And here's the reason why I did it. Which is, like, I am a go supporter if you want to take a gap year. If you're done with high school, this is my opinion on what you should do. It's not advice or anything, but this is like a life hack, you know? Replace the word advice with life hack. Okay, life hack. When you're done with high school, you can... I'm saying this like for the people who are sick and tired of studying, like me, for example. Oh my god, I need my phone on silent. And also, I need to increase my mic, which Alex said that it was low quality. Sorry, Alex. Which is good to have like live feedback. I should always keep my phone with me just in case Alex texts me and says, "Oh, your mic is too muted." Honestly, imagine if like all this time, like how long has it been now? It has been 27 minutes. Imagine if I was talking for 27 minutes and my mic was muted. That would be extremely embarrassing. Anyways, what was I saying again? Oh yeah, right. Life hack. When you're done with high school and you are sick and tired of studying, take a break, which you can. Because the thing is, college is not going to go anywhere. You can just go to college when you're 50. I don't suggest you do that, but you can if you want to. But if you're like, you know what, I don't care, I'm just going to do all this education as soon as possible and get it over with, and go to college for two or three years, and then after that I'm going to go to university or whatever. I'm not telling you how to live a life, it's just what I do. So I took a gap year, and during that gap year I was having a break. But don't get me wrong, I was definitely not having a break that time. I worked a total of 5 or 6, hold on, I gotta count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then, oh my gosh. I worked a total of 6 jobs during a period of 1 year. It was from October of 2020 all the way to September, which is this month, of 2021, which is 11 months. But I used that time to get a job and to work because of two reasons. First of all, I'm broke as hell. And second of all, it was COVID, so I couldn't go to school because it's going to be online. And I strongly despise, I'm not going to use the word hate, even though I would love to use that word, but that word is very negative. So I'm going to say I strongly despise online learning. It is not for me because, first of all, as I mentioned earlier, I don't like technology. So if you're telling me, bonjour class, today we're going to go on Zoom from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m., I'm going to be on Zoom from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m., all right, but I will damn right be asleep during that because I will be in my house, in my bed with my panties or underwear, watching a class, and the teacher says, oh, you have to have your camera on. My camera is on, and I look like a caveman because I've been in my room for the past 6 months. And I'm naked, but the teacher cannot see it because she can only see my face. And she's talking about, like, I don't know, geometrical geology or whatever class people take nowadays. Geometrical biology. She's learning a class of geometrical biology, and meanwhile, I'm just sitting in my bed and eating Doritos. And get this. Online learning, not for everyone, but I can speak for myself. Especially me, because I'm very difficult at concentrating. It's like my Xbox, I don't have an Xbox, my video games, Minecraft, is in the next tab of Zoom. So one wrong click and I'm playing Minecraft. Or one purposely right, like, or maybe like the teacher says something about, and by the way, Montreal president, who's the, not Montreal president, Montreal mayor. Something about the Montreal mayor. Fun fact, I'm going to mention this in an upcoming broadcast, but I'm going to talk about the story where I become a campaign manager. Sorry about that. I got to get a drink. I'm going to talk about the story about, but anyways, what was I saying? Oh my God, I keep getting off track. Anyways, so the Zoom app is right next to Minecraft. So it is very easy for me to move my finger 1 inch and I'm playing Minecraft instead of being in class. So that's the number one reason why online learning is difficult. There have literally been classes where the teacher is talking about a serious subject and I'm literally playing Terraria while she's talking and I'm like, yas queen, you got it. And I'm killing, I don't know, some video game characters. And the teacher is like, so, Hassan, could you please answer the question? I'm like, oh, switch tabs, and I'm back at the Zoom. Could you repeat the question for me? I wasn't paying attention. And the teacher is like, what is the definition of sociological imagination? I literally said this 2 minutes ago, and you should have been listening. And you were listening, because you were looking at the screen, and you were very interested at looking at the screen. I'm like, yes, I was looking at the screen, right. I was interested, and I was definitely paying attention in class. It means, I don't know, something to do with potatoes or farmers. Maybe it has to do with, like, communism and how... And the teacher was like, Hassan, you were playing video games, weren't you? And then she shamed me in front of the class. I'm like, you know what, teacher? You got me. I was playing video games. Because the thing is, if you were playing video games in class, all the students and the teacher would know because you're on your computer or phone. But in Zoom meetings, the teacher has no idea. So you could be, I don't know, watching something that is not for kids. And and it looks like you're watching the class, but you're watching something completely different. I was watching YouTube videos while I'm on my online driving lesson. The teacher was talking about turn signals and other stuff, and I'm like, wow, I didn't know that Thomas the Tank Engine was in a 1986, I don't know, something related to that. And another reason why I strongly despise online learning is because it's not something that makes me pay attention. if I'm in class and, I don't know, the teacher is talking about sociological imagination, I'm going to be paying attention 10% of the class. But if I'm watching a video of a teacher sitting in his bedroom and everyone else in the class has their camera off, and the teacher is just, like, looking at the camera with, I don't know, she's screen recording, screen sharing a PowerPoint that she made yesterday about sociological imagination, I guarantee you I will be paying attention 1% instead of 10%. Because if the teacher is right in front of you, and the teacher is, like, doing body language and facial expressions and walking around the class and doing, like, interactions with the class, it's more interesting, even though it is not interesting. But if you're watching a video of that, all the connection is lost. And you're just, like, looking at a screen of a teacher doing absolutely something you're not interested in. And you're not going to pay attention. So that's another reason why I don't like online learning, is I can't pay attention. And thirdly, is, like, it's very isolating. And if I have a question, I could type it in the chat, or I can ask it. But it's not going to be the same experience, because I can just, like, in class, I can raise my hand and say, "Teacher, could you repeat that?" Or, "Teacher, what does that mean?" And the teacher's like, "Oh, good question." But if I'm like typing in the chat, "Excuse me, what does that mean?" And the teacher's like, "Oh, sorry, I didn't read the chat. That was sent 2 minutes ago. Could you please tell me?" Or like when you're talking on Zoom, you have to unmute your mic and then talk while the teacher is talking, or use the raise hand feature and the teacher doesn't even know what that is. And also because, like, I'm very introverted. I don't like to talk to people. I should be loving online classes, but I'm also kind of, like, starved for social connection. So, like, I'm the type of person who, like, I will literally never talk to you, except once in a blue moon. I would come up to you and say, "Whoa, what's up? How are you doing, my best friend? Want to get some pizza with me?" Only when I'm feeling bored and, like, "Oh my god, I'm so lonely in the cafeteria. Who do I want to talk to today?" I'm like, "Oh my god, there's a person sitting right there. I'm going to talk to them." I can't do that in online learning. I have to talk to myself, or I have to talk to my cat. Like, I can't make friends, which first of all, I'm already horrible at making friends. I, like, the way I make friends is I go to the cafeteria, and I find people who are sitting by themselves, and then, like, I assume that they don't have friends, and I also don't have friends at the time. I have a lot of friends, by the way. What a flex. What a flex. Okay, I didn't mean to flex. I'm sorry. Anyways, so I would go to people who are sitting by themselves because I assume they don't have friends, and I can be friends with them because, get this, if someone doesn't have friends, and then you become friends with them, you are now their only friend, which means they would only hang out with you. Which is something that is definitely not true. Maybe their friends is somewhere else, or maybe they're absent that day, and they're just sitting on the cafeteria. They don't want to be bothered. And it always fails. Like, that person is sitting by themselves for a reason, mostly. Like, they don't want to talk to anyone, or maybe, like, they're waiting for someone, or they're just, they don't want to be involved in anything. And you just come up to them, and so I said, "You know what, this isn't it working." So instead, what I did is, I made friends with what I like to call the snowball effect. If you think, and here's a pro tip for all you introverts like me. If you don't have any friends, all you need is one friend. And it could be anyone. It could even be a teacher. And you can become friends with that person. And if that person just so happened to also have another friend, you can befriend them, and get this, now you have two friends. And then that person has other friends, and then you befriend their friends or whatever, and now you have, like, five friends. And then you join Boys to Men Circle, or you join, I don't know, Overture with the Arts, or you go to summer camp, and you're like working around with people and you're talking, I don't know, maybe in a Boyz II Men circle. Fun fact, a big portion of my friends are from the Boyz II Men circle. So you would be like talking or whatever, and then connections right there. New friends. So that's another life hack. You know what? I should change the title of this because I completely went off topic of the day. I should name this to life hacks instead of time management skills. You know what? Forget about it. The topic of this live broadcast was supposed to be time management, but now I'm going to change it and I'm going to make the topic life hacks. Anyways, I want to go back into the topic because this is a very interesting one. And I literally played a song just to get this. It's called, what is it called again? Oh my gosh. Where is it? There we go. Where does the time go? Worksheet self-assessment exercise. Estimate the number of hours you spend on each task. So, on the topic of time management, this, can you hear this? This is paper. This is paper. I have paper in my hands. And the paper has ink on it, and the ink is lettering. Anyways, so this is like a whatever thing. I don't know what to call it. A worksheet? Self-assessment exercise. Where does this... It's a worksheet. I got it from college. Fun fact. And also, here's another life hack. If you want to meet new people, and you're very awkward, volunteer. Like, maybe there's like a food can drive, or maybe there's like... Or actually join activities, and volunteer also. And chances are other people are volunteering and doing activities, and you would be meeting people who you have something in common with. Therefore, it's not awkward to talk to them because at least you have one thing to talk to them about. Like, for example, I have friends in the LGBT community, and I'm like, nice. So I decided to join an LGBT group. It was called, what was it called again? Gay Straight Alliance, or whatever it was called. It was in Pierrefonds Community High School. It was called the Gay Straight Alliance. And it has nothing to do with being gay or being straight. It has to do with, like, supporting LGBT people and stuff like that. And I decided, you know what, I'm gonna give it a shot. So I joined it, and I met a lot of interesting people who are, to this day, still, like, I talk to them often and stuff. So, like, that's another life hack. Oh my god, 12 minutes remaining. Honestly, like, if I only talked about today's topic, I would have finished an hour ago. And it only started 40 minutes ago. I'm off topic already, man. Anyways. So, this self-assessment exercise is number of hours of sleep each night. Numbers of hours spent grooming each day. Number of hours, meals, snacks, travel time to campus, whatever. So it's like some sort of calculator where personally I sleep 8 to 9 hours a day because I have... Honestly, I'm going to give you a flex. I like that sound. I'm going to give you a flex. I have a good sleep schedule, believe it or not. I sleep every night at 10, and I wake up every morning at, like, 8 or 7, which gives, like, college starts at around 10 a.m. for me, sometimes 11, and sometimes 8. I know, ew, 8 a.m. classes, ew, some people have 7 a.m. classes, even more ew. But, another life hack, if you wanna get a good night's sleep, it's not about when you should wake up, it's about when you should go to sleep. If you have to wake up at 6, sleep at 10. If you have to wake up at 10, sleep at 12. If you want to wake up, etc., etc., just whatever time you have to wake up, minus 8 hours or 9 hours to be more safe, or if you want to get a good rest, minus 10 hours. You like, honestly, in my opinion, 10 hours sleep is much better than 8 hours or 9 hours or even 12 hours, 10 hours of sleep is the, for me at least, is the most perfect amount of sleep. And also, 20 minutes of sleep, or even 1 hour or 2 hours of sleep, like a nap, it's not even sleep, is also very beneficial. Oh my god, I'm talking about... No, I didn't drop anything. I'm talking about sleep, and I keep ignoring... Actually, it is sleep. Never mind. I didn't go off topic. This is... So, I sleep 9 hours a day, times 7, 50... 56? I don't know math. The results come into 56. So, 56 hours of my week is spent sleeping. Number of hours spent grooming each day. Personally, I don't groom very often. Like, I just comb my hair, put on some deodorant, maybe, like, take a 10-minute shower or something. 1 hour, times 7, which is 7, etc. And the answer for me of all the number of hours... Actually, this is another flex. Flex. Number of hours watching Netflix. And I love to flex how I don't watch Netflix, because... On average, I watch 30 minutes of Netflix and YouTube a day, because I'm so good. I'm kidding. It's definitely more than that, because I am lazy. I like to say that I don't watch Netflix, but I very much do. It's like a habit, but it is also entertainment. So anyways, of all these combined, it comes out to 111 hours spent being in the bus, being in class, sleeping, which means in my daily, weekly life, I have 57 hours remaining. And back in the day, I used that time to get a job, but now I don't have a job. I have 57 hours to my... I can do whatever I want. So obviously one of these hours I'm spending it here with Late Night Saturday Night. Last Wave Radio, shout out. You're taking 1 hour of my weekly time. Oof, what was that noise? I love volunteering. Actually, fun fact, today I volunteered at a daycare. And you use your time wisely. If you want to spend 57 hours a week watching Netflix, go for it. If you want, like I mentioned earlier about getting $14.40 every single day, you can use that money and put it into savings. Believe it or not, you can save time. And saving time, and it's like the same thing with money. If you want to make money, you have to spend money. Because if you have $0 and you want to make $1, you just find a dollar on the floor. There you go. You've made a dollar. But now you have a dollar. You can use that money to make more money either by buying something that will make you skilled, such as, like, going to Dollarama. I don't know, you get a spatula or something. It's called investing. You buy a spatula from Dollarama, and then you learn how to flip burgers. And then you become very good at it. And now, with $1, you know how to flip burgers or barbecue. Same thing with me. I had $169 to my disposal. And you know what I bought? I bought a piano keyboard. A small MPK Mini Play AK professional piano keyboard. I bought that. And it was the best decision of my life because I spent $169 and now I can play the keyboard like there's no tomorrow. Like, I can literally play any song you would think of. Maybe not because I'm not skilled. Did I drop my... I got myself a drink just so I don't drink it. So the same thing with time. If you want to make more time in your life, spend the time that you currently have. Let's say you want to be rich, or you want to be famous, or you want to be good in college or good in school. Use your time. I'm gonna come up with an example. Let's say you want to become an artist, like a painter kind of artist. And you're like, I want to be a very famous artist. What does it take? So first of all, do like what I did, like calculate the amount of hours a day, and then schedule. This is the number one thing. Schedule your time. Tell yourself, okay, every Thursday at 6 p.m., I will grab a paintbrush and I will paint. And then every Tuesday at 6 p.m., you grab a paintbrush and you paint. Give yourself a schedule and do so for like, honestly, there's 24 hours in a day. You can do it. It's very, like, people think that success is difficult. But the thing is, it's not the success that is difficult, it's the motivation that is difficult. You could spend 10 hours a week practicing basketball until you become a famous basketball player who's really good at basketball. You could spend 6 hours a day, or 6 hours every 2 weeks, practicing your drawing skills, or your video editing skills, or recording video for your YouTube channel. It's doable, man. You can do it. But the thing is, people don't understand that it's not the action that is hard. It's getting yourself to do it. I have been putting off a lot of tasks lately. Not because they're hard. I can easily do this task right now, such as doing my homework. There's homework that has been due 1 week ago and it's already 1 week overdue. I know I'm a clumsy student. What can I do? And I can just do my homework right now. Like this live broadcast ends in 4 minutes and 26 seconds. And I can just go and do my homework after that. And I would have done my homework. And then I would have submitted the next day. But telling myself, okay, Hassan, I'm going to do homework for, I don't know, 1 hour. And then while I'm 1 hour of doing homework, I'm like, ugh, this is so hard. Oh, boo-hoo. Well, it's just coming up with excuses because deep inside, you don't want to do homework. You don't want to do this. You don't want to practice basketball. You do not want to go to the gym and work out and lose some weight because you're just not comfortable doing it. And the thing is, you can't succeed if you're comfortable. Spoiler alert. If you're like, I'm comfortable sitting in my bed. Where's my money? You're not getting it, hun. Money is not going to come to you. You have to come to the money or to the success. You have to get out of your blanket-filled pillow bed. Get out of your underwear and get dressed and take a shower probably because you smell bad for sitting in your bed for 2 days. And then just go on and do the thing that you have been putting off for a while. Oh my god, my cat. By the way, meet my cat. Hello, cat. Do you have anything to say? That's my cat, by the way. And you can, like, it's so easy. People don't understand how easy it is. It is difficult for the motivation, but the task itself is easy. Oh, boo-hoo, I'm uncomfortable doing this. Of course you're uncomfortable doing this because you want to go home and watch Netflix. That's what you deep inside want. Anyways, this live broadcast is going to end in like 2 minutes anyway. I'm just talking out of my donkey. I don't want to say the bad word. So right now we're just going to... What am I going to do for 2 minutes? I can't even talk about something for 2 minutes. I'm going to talk about it for an hour. So think in advance. Thank you for listening to this live broadcast. My name is Hassan Dejani, a.k.a. DJ Pink Shoelace. I love making noises. Make some noise! Hit the club! Make some... My biggest dream is I want to DJ at a nightclub. And I want all that kind of stuff, you know? That's my biggest dream. Like, bucket list, DJ a nightclub. After I'm done, I don't know what I'm gonna do after that. Like, I've hit the peak of my life. I'm just gonna, like, you know what? I lived a good life. And the thing is, it doesn't take much to live a good life. Believe it or not. Literally, another life hack. If you want to be happy, and I'm speaking for myself, life hack, not advice, whatever. If you want to be happy, do something that makes you happy, and then once you're doing it, as easy as that, smile. Because Michael Stevens from Vsauce, shout out to Vsauce, he did a study where, like, he forced people to smile by putting, like, a stick in their mouth or something. And then they reported that they were happy versus the people who weren't forced to smile. So forcing yourself to smile and not like a creepy way, like, forcing yourself to smile will literally make you happier. And it is proven by studying, as well as doing things that you enjoy doing, such as petting puppies, petting kittens, etc. Anyways, I gotta end because the live broadcast is gonna end in 35 seconds. Oh, shoot. I've never felt this pressured before. Pink Shoelace Boy, DJ Pink Shoelace signing out, Last Wave Radio, Laval Senior Academy, Late Night Saturday Night with Pink Shoelace, signing out. I'll see you next week. Shout out to Youth Stars Community, shout out to Overture with the Arts, shout out to Ian Spencer, shout out to Alex Von Miller, shout out to Riverdale High School, shout out to Pierrefonds Community High School, shout out to Boystom in Canada, what can I do in 3 seconds? Shout out to my sister, shout out to... The live ended. Now this is just you and me, people who are listening from the future. I'll see you all tomorrow. Peace and love. Bye-bye.